And Virgo, what do we have for you, Virgo? Virgo, you have the Ten of Wands and the Seven of Cups. So I feel like you're releasing burdens at this time, Virgo. The Seven of Cups is like a focus. So I feel like you need to focus on what you want in life and get rid of the rest, is what this says. Ten of Wands says like maybe you want a job, but maybe you're just too focused on like everything else that's going on around you. So really, I feel like you need to be like a little bit more greedy, a little bit more self-focused here with these cards. And I feel like you just need to like pay attention to yourself right now, give yourself a lot of like energy and attention and like all that other good stuff. So that's what I would say here with these two cards. For others, I feel like for some of you, this could be someone running away from a relationship from you, or it could have been you running away from them, I guess, but it could go either way, Virgo. I feel like this comes up for you all the time that somebody ran away from you. Like I said, it could be vice versa, whatever, if you're a cross watcher, but I feel like you're about to release burdens from that situation, is what I would say to you here with these two cards. Next, you have the Page of Pentacles in the World. So I feel like for a lot of you, Virgos, there's like new love coming in. Page of Pentacles to me is new love. So I feel like there's definitely a new relationship coming in for you with the Page of Pentacles. And I feel like it could be another earth sign. You always get Capricorn showing up in your reading, so that doesn't really surprise me. The World just says like open up to the world. So I feel like you need to get out there and date if you're looking for love. Definitely, like I always say to you, Virgo, I feel like there could be some sort of move coming in for you where you're like moving or you are like traveling or something like that with the World. And this is saying like a move or travel would be a really good idea for you with the World card, because that could bring love in, or it could bring in attention into your life with these two cards. For others, I feel like this could be a new job that requires travel or moving. So I feel like some of you could be like getting a new job or could be traveling because of these two cards. And I like it. And finally, Virgo, Eight of Pentacles, Queen of Swords, material success on the horizon. So I almost just ended the stream. So let's not do that by accident, right? I feel like there could be a lot of attention coming in for you with the Eight of Pentacles and happiness. To me, Eight of Pentacles is material success on the horizon. The Queen of Swords is like truth, justice, and clarity coming in for you. So I feel like there's a lot of truth, justice, and clarity coming in for you with the Queen of Swords. Eight of Pentacles could be like a lot of money coming in the future. To me, Eight of Pentacles doesn't say you will be rich, but it says like, you know, there's financial potential coming in for you. Queen of Swords to me is a card of like, again, focusing on yourself. So I feel like it would be just a good day, couple of days here for you to like pay attention to yourself and really give yourself all the attention that you know, all the attention like on yourself, basically. I feel like this could also be talking about experience, because Eight of Pentacles is a card of mastery. The Queen of Swords is a card of experience and experiences that you have. And it's like a card of like paying attention to your experiences as well. So I feel like a lot of you need to like trust your own experience with these two cards. But I feel like you could be learning something as well. You could be gaining experience with those two cards also. So thank you, Virgo. That looks pretty good.